Yeah, good morning. This is Pastor Bernard Bolton coming to you from the Danville Mall in Danville, Virginia. I'm here walking. Good morning, Pastor Joe. How's it going, brother? Good morning, Diva. Good to have you on this morning. Thanks for the hearts. Thanks for the hearts. I don't always be catching on with the hearts. Yes, good morning, sir. Thanks for joining us. Good morning to you, Diva. Glad to have you on this morning. Good morning, Vantoria. Then I already told you, Van. Good morning, though, didn't I? But good morning again. Good to have my wife on. All right. I'm going to try to get my 3 miles in today. I never walk more than an hour. And so if I can get 3 miles in, that's good. Yes, sir. Good morning, Elder. Good to have you on with us this morning. I pray you're doing well. Wine Geeker. That's an unusual name. Are you a winemaker? Okay. Listen, I've got a couple of things to talk about today. So this is the first of two broadcasts. I really wanted to talk about, how does God speak to you? How do you discern when God is speaking to you? How do you discern when, you know, God is showing you something? And I wanted to really share with you, and this is one of the ways that God speaks to me. Now, the thing I want to say is that God has a range of ways to speak to us, to get our attention and to cause us to pay attention to what's happening around us. God really doesn't have one method of speaking. And I believe that that's true because God is relational. And, you know, he doesn't talk to us. Thanks for joining, 2Clap from Russia. Bless you. Bless your nation, sir. Yeah. Thank you for being on. Because God is relational, he speaks to us regarding who we are. And so he has to come to us. You know, how he speaks to me may not be the same way that he speaks to you. Now, of course, God speaks through his word. But even that can be kind of messy, because so many people in the church, they try to make the word what they want it to say rather than trying to hear what God is saying. And then other people are so intellectual about the word is that they receive the word as letter, but they don't receive the word as spirit. See, a lot of times when we're interpreting the scriptures and we're reading the scriptures, we need to be trying to capture what the heart of God in that scripture, not just be stuck in the letter, okay? Because the letter kills. And so when we are reading the word, interpreting the word, we want to do it in the spirit. We want to ask the Holy Spirit to show us what he is saying and to give us revelation. We want to read several different versions of the Bible. I've got like three versions right at my fingertip. I've got the New King James. I've got the New American Standard. And then I have the Complete Jewish Bible. And to be quite honest with you, the Complete Jewish Bible is about the best translation of the scriptures. But we want to capture the spirit of the word. And so a lot of times when we only get the letter of the word, good morning, Lady T, glad to have you on. When we only capturing the letter, then our interpretation is kind of skewed. The word of God is living and active, and that means it is spirit. And if you're not getting it in the spirit, you're not going to get it. Well, okay, I've given you all that part. But I wanted to talk about how does God speak. One of the primary ways that God speaks to me, and again, he may not speak to you this way, but God speaks to me through numbers. And when I start seeing numbers, and I'm seeing them several times a day, wow, like I'm just looking. The person that just came on, they have the number 999777. Well, 777, that's one of the prophetic numbers that God speaks to me through. The number 7 is a prophetic number in my life. And so I just got a message from God from that person who came on, okay? But anyway, God starts speaking in numbers. So Lady Diva, who I know is a prophet of God and who hears God very clearly. Hello, Helen, good to have you on. She said God speaks to her in numbers. So there may be a number of you who hear God in numbers and you may not be picking up on what God is saying, or you may not be paying attention because you have a religious mindset. And I say this, I say this not out of offense or judgment, but when you have a religious mind, the only way you think God can speak is through a preacher. And you got to be in a building on a certain day. And listen, the truth of the matter is, if you are a member of a church, yes, God will speak to you. I know God speaks to me. He gives me words for the congregation that I minister to every week because I'm a pastor. But here's the thing. If God only speaks to you through a man or a woman in a building once a week, then you're missing out on a lot of conversation. And the truth of the matter is, most of us only retain about 2% of the message that we hear from our pastors. 2%, we forget the other 98%. And so if you're not capturing what you're hearing on Sunday, you're not recording it, your church is not recording it, they're not making it available to you, then you're really not hearing God. And then a lot of people, they only want to hear God for 30 minutes. So if your pastor preaches 40 minutes, if he preaches 50 minutes, then you have tuned him out and you're just looking at the clock like, man, when is this rascal going to sit down? So we have to know that God is speaking. He's always speaking, and we have to discern how to hear him. So yesterday, I got an invitation from a prophet, and I don't remember her first name, but her last name is Susa. And so I got this invitation from her to join her on a webinar that she's doing tonight at 9 o'clock. And in the webinar, she was talking about she's going to be teaching on Deuteronomy 1:11. Okay. So that captured my attention because God has been speaking to me from the number 11 for a couple of weeks now. The number 11 is the number of transition. And I've been, you know, and so as I've been tuning my ear to hear what God is saying, I've been really getting a lot of messages about transition. Many of us are in transition. Many of us are, we're in the middle. Okay, we've left the old, but we haven't quite come into the new. But then when I read that message about Deuteronomy 1:11, she's going to be teaching tonight, that piqued my interest because that particular verse is talking about how God says, I'm going to make you 1,000 times better and I'm going to bless you, as I've said. And so, wow, look at that. My friend from Georgia said he was on his job for 11 years. See that? See, that's God. That's God. And so he's in the midst of transition, but he's getting ready to go to a greater place. God's got a wealthy place for you, my brother. Yes, sir. So in the midst of that message, as I was listening to that, reading that message, brother, I looked at my inbox And in my inbox was the number 111. I had 111 messages in my inbox. So I knew that God was speaking with me. Okay? So I was like, yeah, I've got to be on that call tonight. So this morning, I was listening to a message from Apostle Dutch Sheets, and he began to talk about the number 11 in his message. And he says that there was a season in his life about 5 years ago where all he was seeing was the number 11. Everywhere he went, the number 11. He'd go, he was everywhere he was going, he was seeing the number 11. And then the Spirit came to him and says, I'm about to change your numbers from 11 to 111. He said that in a message. Now, get this. He preached that message about 10 months ago. But I was listening to it. And as he began to talk about the number 111, I knew God was speaking to me. I knew God said, now, what is God saying? Because the number 11 is the number of transition. But the number one is the number of resources, okay? In the Hebrew alphabet, the first letter, the first Hebrew letter is the letter Aleph. And it has the number because the Hebrew letter not only has letters, but their letters are actually pictures, but they also have numerical value. So the first letter in the Hebrew alphabet is the letter Aleph, and the numerical value is number one. Well, the picture, because the Hebrew letter, the Hebrew alphabet is composed of pictures. So what we call letter is actually pictures. Well, guess what? The number one, or the letter Aleph, is the ox. It's the ox. And in the Bible, the ox represents resources and provision. All right. Remember the story of Elisha. Elijah came to him and threw the mantle on him. And Elisha had, I think he had 10 oxen. Well, in that time, a person's wealth was determined by the number of oxen that he had, because those oxen were actually they would use their oxen. The more oxen the person had, the more land that they could sow and harvest. Okay? The more oxen that they had, the more wagons that they had to carry provision. So what is the number 11? 111 means? It means that in the midst of transition, God is bringing great provision. Man, I started leaping when I got that revelation. And then the Holy Spirit told me to start reading all of the verses in the Bible that was in chapter 1, verse 11, from Genesis to Revelation. So I looked at the verses, Genesis 1, 11. I went all the way through the scriptures. And this is another way that the Holy Spirit gives me revelation when he's dealing with me regarding numbers. And so I was looking at all of the verses that started from Genesis 1:11 to Revelation 1:11. And in Genesis 1:11, it talks about the third day of creation, where God says he told the grass to come forth. He told the herb that bared seed to come forth. All right. And then he said, no, it's not just you. It's not just you, prophet. It's a lot of us. So praise God for identity, for God identifying this to us in this hour. And so God says that he would bring forth the grass, he would bring forth the herb yielding seed, and he would bring forth the tree that has in itself the seed. Okay, now I want you to get this, because that's a transitional verse, but it reveals the provision of God. And what that verse was saying to me, and I pray it may say something different to you, but what it was saying to me is that everything that I need has already been placed in me. All of my provision, all of my resources has been planted in me. And so, like the tree planted by the rivers of water, whatsoever I do is going to prosper, and I'm going to bring forth fruit in due season. So I pray that's a word for you today. So in the midst of your transition, look for your provision and your resources. Hallelujah. Yes, sir, it's in us, God. All we got to do is call it forth and bring it out. All the strategies you need, all the ideas you need, the provision that you need, it's not outside of you. So you don't have to look for it in the world. You just got to look in you, because you are a tree. And the seed of your greatness and the seed of your provision is on the inside of you. All right. I'm going to get out of here. All right. This brother prophecy said he had two jobs and he kept them for 11 years. Man, that's an awesome testimony. Bless you. Bless you. All right, y'all. I'm going to get out of here and try to finish these laps so I can get back. I got to go see some people at the hospital. Yes, thank you. Bless you. Thank you for being on with us. Oh, that's Prophet Talisha. Man, I'm so honored to have all these prophets on with us, and apostles on, and pastors and teachers. I just bless you. And I bless the gifts in all of you. Thank you, sir. Connect with me on Facebook, Watchmen on Walls International Fellowship. And go to my website, creativeawakenings.us. And if you haven't gotten my latest book yet, The 70, A Movement of Creativity in the Earth, that's available on Amazon. All right. Y'all take care. Shalom.